Interested in making your stories more flexible by allowing your users to customize how information is displayed? You can leverage scripting in SAP Analytics Cloud to implement functionality that enables your users to select which measures are applied to a data visualization. In the previous video in this series, you created a dashboard in which users can toggle between table and chart visualizations of the same data. In this video, you'll add a checkbox group and programmatically load it with the measures from the model and configure some buttons to deselect and select all the values in the checkbox group. Keep in mind, you must be in advanced mode to create a checkbox group widget. You can delete the default values that were added, as you'll soon be loading values into the checkbox programmatically. Make sure to give the newly created widget a unique name so you can easily reference it in your script. In the styling panel, you can modify the information of the widget, such as its label. You can also modify the appearance of the widget to suit your preferences. Now that you've added the checkbox group, you can add all the measures as checkbox options. First, you can create a script variable to store all the measures. In SAP Analytics Cloud, you can use script variables to store a value of a specific type. Script variables offer the advantage of being reusable throughout your script. Give the script variable a descriptive name, set the type to string, and enable the toggle to make the script variable an array. In scripting, an array is a collection of multiple elements of the same type, so this is a script variable that stores an array of strings. Once you've created the script variable, you can add scripting to programmatically load the measures as checkbox values. This should happen when the page loads, so you can apply the script to the onInitialization event of the page. First, create a variable to store the measures from the data source of the table. Inside this variable, you can access the data source of the table in your story and retrieve the measures from its data source. The measures variable now stores an array of measures. You can iterate over each measure inside this array and load it as an option in the checkbox group widget. First, you'll need to write an if statement to check for errors and ensure that the array is not empty. In scripting, an if statement is a way to run code only if a specified condition is met. To check if the measures variable is empty, begin by writing the keyword if, followed by the condition enclosed within parentheses and a pair of braces. Inside these braces, you can define the block of code that will run if the condition is true. You can iterate over each element in the measures array using a for loop. Begin with the keyword for to start the loop. You can initialize a counter variable to keep track of the loop's current position. Then you can define the condition that will keep the loop running as long as its value is true. This indicates how many times the loop will run. Next, you can update the counter by incrementing the loop variable after each iteration, followed by a pair of braces. Inside the braces, you can write the script for adding each element inside the measures array to the checkbox group widget. To do this, you can call the addItem method on the checkbox group, supplying the ID and the description of the current measure in the loop as parameters. You can also append the ID of each measure to the allMeasure script variable initialized earlier. To ensure that all the checkbox values are selected by default, you can call the setSelectedKeys method on the checkbox group and pass the allMeasure script variable as a parameter. After you've completed writing the script to load all the measures within the checkbox group, you can save your changes and switch over to view mode to see the results. You'll notice that the checkbox group has been updated to include all the measures from the data visualization, with all measures selected by default. You can select and deselect each option as needed. Keep in mind that you have not yet set up the scripting to pass this selection to the table and chart, so selecting values here does not yet change the visualizations. To further increase the flexibility of your story, you can enable users to easily select or deselect all options by adding button widgets below the checkbox group to perform each action. To make them easy to reference in your script, you can give each button widget a distinct name. You can also customize their labels to describe their functionality. You can apply the button class name to these button widgets so that they match the style of the other buttons. To select all the options when the associated button is clicked, you can apply a script to its onClick event. Call the setSelectedKeys method on the checkbox group and pass the allMeasures script variable as a parameter. You can repeat the same process for the other button, passing an empty array as a parameter instead. Once you've written the logic for the buttons, you can save your changes again and switch over to view mode to see it in action. You'll observe that clicking the Remove All button deselects the checkbox options, while clicking Select All reselects them. In the next video in the series, you'll learn how to build on the logic demonstrated here so that measures selected in this checkbox group are reflected in the table and chart. For more information on filtering tables and charts using the selections of the checkbox group, visit the help topic links in the description and try it for yourself today.